And another painful series is in the books. And painful is an understatement with this road trip as a whole.
That is correct.
The bats still have our ice cold. We were like, this is very, very different from that one game we had in Seattle a couple weeks ago. It's got to change. I agree with you. The offense definitely needs to step it up. I'm surprised how the bats have just been hanging in the freezer the whole darn time. Also, another thing that is concerning for me is Joe Maddon's overmanaging. Why would you take out Quintana, though he's our worst starter, after 74 pitches when he's cruising, and go to a guy whose ERA is a sub-5, and he predictably gave up a 3-run home run in that same amount of time? Really, Joe? Well, at least that game did not turn out as badly as some other ones on this road trip. Now let's get to this episode. Welcome everybody to episode 13 of the Angels Recap Series. Today previewing the series against the Boston Red Sox in Boston. A bad, bad series as a whole, as we discussed in the intro with the overly loyal Angels fan. The bats have been stuck in the freezer, frozen, barely able to produce any offense, specifically talking about game 2 where we were shut out 9-0 and somehow managed to get 2 hits. How did we even get 2 hits? I was just thinking we were going to get no hit, but we somehow got 2 hits in that game. Some good in that series. Friday we showed some fight. Griffin Canning had another solid performance. In his last 3 starts, Griffin Canning had only allowed 1 home run in that time.
Hey,
I'm not sure if that was prior to his start or after his start. I'm going to think it was prior to it, but prior to his start, he had only allowed 1 home run, and all he gave up in terms of scoring was a 2-run home run to Hunter Renfro. But other than that, he's been really good. The strikeouts have been there, and he's been giving us quality starts. It's a shame that the offense wasn't able to produce behind him in that. However, in game 1, Shohei Ohtani hit a monster shot off of Nick Pivetta.
Tried to go out there again with the breaking ball. Shohei hits it toward the monster and gone. And he flicks it out.
If we were talking in terms of distance, it wasn't that monstrous. I think that only went about 385 feet, but the strength that he had to get it over the monster, that's what they call it in Boston, is incredible. You saw, he just, as they even Gooby said on the video, he flicked, essentially, a flick of the wrist strong enough to propel the ball out of the ballpark on the bounce, out of the seats. That was a great swing from Ohtani to get them back in the game, but Watson would allow a 2-run homer to Bobby Dalbec with Joe Maddon trying to play matchup and who to bring out of the bullpen.
Oops.
I mean, Watson is a good pitcher, but lefty on righty is generally not a good move. In the second game, 9-0 shutout. The less said about that game, the better. But you know what my favorite part about that game was, guys? Was the ending of that game. Mercifully, that game had an ending. But in the third game, the Angels... Since when do the Angels win games? That's blasphemy to me. The Angels won a game? Wow. I'll take it. A win's a win. Whether it's ugly or it's convincing, a W is a W. I should also inform you that before game 2 of this series, the Angels got a new player on their team.
Let's take a look and see.
The new guy that we got, Hunter Strickland. Yes, we got Hunter Strickland via trade from the Tampa Bay Rays. Strickland is an experienced reliever in this league. 32 years old, goes 6'3", 225, an 18th round draft pick back in 2007 of the Boston Red Sox. But he didn't get into the league until 7 years after his draft year, where he spent five seasons with the Giants. And if you know about the Giants when Strickland was with them, you may remember his fight with Bryce Harper in 2017. I'm not going to show that because I don't like to show violence on this YouTube channel. But he has a lot of experience, as I mentioned. He's a career 3.13 ERA, which is pretty solid.
Hey, that's pretty good.
He can be used as a backup closer or a setup man. Pretty good move by GM Perry Minasian, in my opinion. With all that being said now, let's shift into our next topic and discuss the third game of the series and then preview our next series back at the Big A with the Cleveland Indians. With the injuries that have really started to plague this team in terms of our hitters, Stassi's still out, hopefully he comes back soon. We have had to mix up the lineup in a few very creative ways. And here's a new twist. Of all people to be leading off, we have Jose Rojas leading off in this game. But he went 0 for 5 today with 2 strikeouts. Oof. So the scoring in this game, the Angels would jump out right away to a 4-0 lead. And they got an RBI single from Taylor Ward, which is good to see. Ward was pretty underrated last year, if you don't remember him from the COVID-shortened season. Hall of Famer Phil Gosselin.
Are you sure about that?
Gets his third double somehow already with the Angels, and he's hitting over 300, so he's almost up there in average with Mike Trout. Unbelievable. And of all people, a career 198 hitter by the name of Drew Butera, who you may remember we got just prior to the Dodgers series, gets an two RBI single to cap off the four-run inning. Jose Quintana pitched solidly, but he made a mistake in the bottom of the third, giving up a double to Jonathan Arauge. That was his first career base hit. And then, after surrendering a home run to catcher Kevin Plawecki in the bottom of the fifth, Joe Maddon decides to get creative, in his opinion at least, by pulling Quintana after only 74 pitches, and there were two runners on base at this moment. He brings in Aaron Sleggers, the tallest man in baseball today and on the Indian Angels history. But it doesn't matter if you're the tallest when you implode and you give up a three-run home run to the next guy up, Rafael Devers, one of the players I highlighted to watch in the preview. Ay, ay, ay. And the next three innings would go scoreless, and Matt Barnes is in, and there's two outs in the ninth inning. Mike Trout is the last hope for all of the Angels in this game. He got a base hit?
That is ridiculous!
That's his first hit in nearly six games! Unbelievable! And now, the Angels put the tying run on base, and the challenger, next one at least, Shohei Ohtani, steps up to the plate looking to make a miracle. The friendly confines of Fenway Park help us out there in getting the win, or at least in taking the lead. Mike Mayers would come in, got a little dicey, but he gets a big swing and miss from Michael Chavis to secure the W.
Mike with a 1-2. Got him!
So our next series will be taking place at the Big A against the Cleveland Indians, and we'll start with the pitching matchups. Cleveland has always been known for having really good pitchers. I'm looking right at you, Shane Bieber. You won the Cy Young last year, and he is not related to Justin Bieber, folks. So it will be, for game one, we'll get Sam Hentges versus Patrick Sandoval, the battle of the lefties. Sandoval will be on a pitch count after pitching 40 innings out, or pitches out of the bullpen last time out. Pitch count specifically is going to be about 60 to 65. Hentges is going to be making his second career start. Currently is 1-0 with a 3.29 ERA. For game two, we have Zach Plesac versus Andrew Heaney. Righty versus lefty. Plesac is 3-3 with a 3.56 ERA. Andrew Heaney comes in 1-3 with a 4.75 ERA. In his previous start against Seattle, Plesac flirted with a no-no, not literally, into the bottom of the eighth inning, where he then surrendered two runs. He is a very, very good pitcher. That's a tough matchup, and another even tougher matchup is going to be the third starter, Aaron Civale, for Cleveland, going up against Shohei Ohtani in Game 3. I wonder if we'll see pitcher and hitter Shohei. Civale is 5-1 with a 3.4 ERA, and Ohtani is 1-0 with a 2.1 ERA. Cesar Hernandez is the second baseman. He is the contact hitter. He always just slaps the ball all over the place, so keep your eye on him. Big Franmil Reyes, the Franimal. And when I mean big, I'm not joking, guys. 6'5", 265. He can hit some titanic moonshots. Jose Ramirez, the third baseman, wearing number 11. Let's watch for Josh Naylor, the right fielder. For our Halos players to watch, let's watch, of course, for Shohei Ohtani. I'm sure he can hit another bomb. If he does play this series, I'm going to go a little crazy and say watch for Phil Gosselin, because he's actually been swinging a pretty good bat. And let's also watch for Jose Iglesias. The reason I'm leaving the big names off of here is because they've just been ice cold and they haven't been doing a whole lot. So just a change up for this episode, maybe I'll put their names back in players to watch in our series for next week. And so I know it's a little surprising, but it's my opinion and I think we can all roll with it. So that one of those two pitchers I wanted you to watch for is James Karinchak, setup man. He can be a closer too. He has this really unique delivery where he pushes the glove out there, just does it really quickly, and then he just fires a 99 mile an hour fastball right at you. It's an unhittable pitch. And then the other guy is Emmanuel, Clase, who they got in the trade of Corey Kluber. And he's got a 101, 102 mile an hour cutter that's just as unhittable as any pitch thrown from James Karinchak. A win of this series against Cleveland would be great, because we're 5-10 this month. But I still think we're going to lose this series. So I'm going to go with the prediction of 7-5 in game one, in game two with Plesac going for Cleveland. I think the Angels are going to lose this game by a score of 8-3, and then the Ohtani versus Civale matchup, I think the Angels will be able to be the victors in that one and come out on top by a score of 4-2. All right, guys, that is going to be it for this episode. Let me know in the comments section below the video what you thought. Remember to click like and subscribe. Hopefully this one is not late. Have a good day. Stay safe. Let's go, Angels. And let's get another win. Let's go, boys.